Stand him up.
Oh, shit. Doc.
You come to us like a snake in the grass. Here, in a city of lies. You are the biggest liar of them all.
What the hell are you talking about? Answer me, motherfucker!
Yes. Lose control. That is what you Americans are so good at, after all. If I...
Not bad.
Clear out the corpses. Leave, Crane.
Yes, sir.
Ugh.
even spread. Such a shame you'll be a corpse by then. Is this your first feeble attempt at controlling your own destiny, Crane? Too little, too late, I fear. Impressive! For a walking dead man.
Thank you.
eyes again. Oh.
You have provided some quality entertainment for my men. Too bad it's a one-time performance. This will only prolong the inevitable. But try to make the best of it, huh? Let no one say I never gave you anything, Crane. Your skills no longer come as a surprise, Crane. The GRE selects its operatives well.
Shit.
Lower the platform.
Drop the weapon. Chaos, Crane. Chaos is the one true order of things. But to pretend otherwise is the sheerest folly. Allow me to demonstrate.
Bassam, can you hear me?
Loud and clear.
Publish the file.
Right away, sir. And there. Easy,
you maniac. You just doomed thousands of innocent people! That's what you get with your fucking chaos!
You don't know what was on that file, do you, Crane? You only prove my point for me. The GRE plans to weaponize the virus, not cure it. They're only interested in profit, not saving lives. And by following their rules, you have become their trained monkey. Pathetic. All right. Kill him.
Doc, come on, let's get you out of here.
Crane, save these people. They don't deserve all of this.
You, give me that torch. Crane! What are you squaring waiting for? Shoot him!
I'm sorry, Doc.
There you are! Hey, look, over there!
Thank you.
I found a way out of the arena. Now I gotta haul ass back to Brecken. But Zara, he didn't make it. He said he gave his research to Jade before Rice grabbed him, so there might still be a shred of hope for a cure.
This again? Oh! Again.
To hide you at the pier. Half of Rice's men are after you. Whatever you've done, it's really put them on the warpath.
I have to talk to Jade. Zara, he gave her his research.
She took it to Camden. Well, she tried to. Camden radioed that Rice's thugs had found his lab. So he flooded it with biters and barricaded himself in the middle. Now he's trapped. Then the connection failed. We haven't been able to raise him since.
I'm going after her. How is she getting in? That part of town is sealed off.
There's a group called the Saviors that smuggles people through. They have a den at Nico's bar in the Cauldron near the highway. The contact's name is Cenk.
Do you have enough runners to cover airdrops?
The airdrops stopped 36 hours ago. There won't be any more. We're out of time, Crane.
Shit. All right. I don't know if I can fix this, but I'm sure as hell gonna try.
You know, most men in your situation will crawl into a hole and hide. Hats off to you, mate, and good luck.
Hey, Crane, here's your gear. Best regards from Kareem.
Kareem, huh? If you see him, thank him for me.
I'm Neil Fallon. I'm a journalist for International Affairs magazine.
Yeah, I've heard of you.
You have?
How the hell'd you get in here?
It wasn't so hard during the first few days of the quarantine. And when they put Suleiman in charge, it was pretty clear how things were going to go.
So you decided to stick around?
Actually, I've decided to leave. Though God knows how that's going to happen. I've been in some lockdown cities before, but there's usually someone you can bribe. Not here.
I can't get you out of Haran. I'm not sure anyone can.
No, of course. But I've been documenting this place, pretty much from day one. I've interviewed hundreds of, well, people who aren't people anymore. Suleiman has a lot to answer for. The world needs to know what's happened, and look, I'm kind of desperate here. I've lost my work, all of it. I was holed up at an internet cafe when a mob of infected landed on me. I got out without a bite, but I left my satchel at the cafe.
And everything's in the satchel?
Most of it. They chased me for a while, so I finally had to ditch my camera in a car. Look, I know it's a lot to ask.
All right, even if I recovered them, you still don't have a way out of here.
Mister, if I can't get my work back, there's no reason for me to get out.
Now that cafe's in a bad area. I'll think about it, but no promises, okay?
Somebody's in the school. Our scouts spotted people entering the building.
Wouldn't have made it without you.
Keep it away!
Oh! one more thing, mate. Do you remember that girl from Sector Zero, Troy?
Yeah, she called to thank me after I got the antenna towers working.
You should contact her when you get there.
Good idea. Thanks, Brecken.
Right. You take care.
Forget about the zombies. There is something far more terrible. A living nightmare that walks among us.
Just calm down and tell me what's going on.
I am Babar Kizam, and I am the victim of a most terrible and ancient curse. I am a lycanthrope.
A what?
A lycanthrope. A werewolf. You have seen the undead all around you. Is it so unlikely that other such monsters are here as well? The Nosferatu, the Mummy, the lycanthrope. Dahlia the Witch says I can be cured if I ingest a potion of garlic, wolf's bane, and a teaspoon of cinnamon. Help me collect these things and get me to another safe zone. I will pay you very, very well.
Ugh. I just want to talk.
Try listening. The first bullet goes over your head. The next one goes through it.
Stop it, Edward. You don't want to scare off someone who might be willing to help us.
We don't know this arsehole from a plate of falafel.
Don't argue with me. Let him in.
Seems Errol wants to talk to you.
There won't be any trouble.
Do I look worried?
Scared to death.
He's perceptive. Come in, come in. I'm Errol.
Kyle Crane.
This is my niece, Salier, and her son, Aaron. Do forgive Edward, but he's completely right to be worried. We're being pursued by some very ruthless men.
There's something oddly familiar about you.
There should be. The campaign spent a lot of money putting my face all over town.
Of course, you're Errol Asani, governor of the province.
Governor of nothing, but Rise has decided that any political figure is a threat to him. So he's ordered my execution. They nearly killed me once already. That's how I lost my leg. And it seems they haven't given up. A squad of his thugs has tracked me to my last safe house in the slabs. Edward was just there. He says they're searching the area. It's only a matter of time before they show up here.
Sounds like you got quite a problem.
I would pay you very well to resolve it.
You know, people say that a lot to me.
Trust me. What I can offer you can't be found anywhere else, at any price.
And I'll think about it.
That was a close call, my friend.
Thank you. I saw that area after the explosion. Just a pile of rubble.
My brother-in-law lost a thumb too. Of course, that was to a German shepherd, not a son of a bitch with an assault rifle. Totally ruined the upholstery in my car on the way to the hospital. They tried to reattach the thumb, but oh, the dog had chewed it up pretty bad. So they did a thumb transplant, except it wasn't a thumb. Hitchhike better than anybody.
Found some crayons! Oh, fantastic, you're the best. The kids are gonna lose their minds, but in a good way. Here, take this. You'll make better use of it than I will.
You got it? Great. Here's the key I promised you. It's to my old pawn shop, you know? Used to be the best in town. Hey, speaking of the pawn shop, would you do me another favor? I need you to bring me something from the shop. You're going there anyway, right?
What is it?
It's a... Don't laugh, okay? It's a Ray McCall action figure. I know it sounds silly, but it means a lot to my son.